Hey, everyone. I am here with Tom Arnold. Tough business, huh?
Do you say tough business or talk business? Tough business? Yeah. Well, I mean, if you don't like rejection, if you're very hypersensitive, then you don't want to be in it. But if you know that that's part of it for everybody, including the most successful people, and you're willing to do the real hard work, you know, if you're willing to support your career by doing whatever it takes, you know, I mean, when I first started, I was a stand-up comic, and I was also a bartender and a bouncer and whatever, and it beat working at Hormel, where I worked for 3 years. And if you're willing to, you know, to be an actor, let's say, because you love it, I mean, and you're willing to just, your goal is to get opportunities, not results, but yeah, of course you want to be, you know, and if your goal is to be an actor and not famous, because anybody can be famous, all you got to do is kill a bunch of people, but to be if that's really your goal, then you go for it, you know.
Is there a misconception out there that you think that maybe the young people starting off in this business just don't quite understand?
Yeah, I'm glad I was stupid enough to not understand how hard it was, because I left Iowa with $100 and a trash bag full of clothes and moved to Minneapolis to be a stand-up comic. I had a job offer. I thought it was full-time. It was a one weekend for $15. And I wouldn't have left the University of Iowa if I had any sense. I would have been a stockbroker working with my uncle. I would have stayed on Hormel for 50 years like my grandpa. Or it was just crazy. I was crazy. But you had something to do. And later on, you're grateful that you did that, because you wouldn't be here at the Explore Talent website, which is on the internet, talking about it. And so, you know, I've done 60 films. I've done all this stuff. And I feel, it's hard to remember, but I feel grateful. And sometimes I should feel more grateful than I do. But the best part about being famous is that you can raise a lot of money for your charities, and you know, my advice too is, you know, it's a reverse thing. How do I get an agent? Well, I got to get a job first, then I get an agent. It's a real tough thing. Get out, get with people that are starting out too, network with them. It's also good to have people to talk about, you know, the pain of not getting something, or the being humiliated, or whatever.
Misery loves company sometimes.
Misery loves company. I mean, it's just like a 12-step group, and then you get your chance, and be sure you're ready for your chance, because anybody can open doors for you, but it's what happens then. Because if you don't have the goods, then that might be your only chance. But that's what I recommend to people. It's a crazy life. It's a crazy thing, but it's just a job. It's not who you are. And if you feel too good about yourself, Google your own name and read the blogs.